welcome once again to Retro, Getting It All Back. Oh, I pray that you're just ready to experience the move of God that went on here, can come right into your family room and to wherever you're watching this program today, because the Holy Spirit is doing miraculous things here. Folks are becoming so fired up with the power of the Holy Ghost. It doesn't matter what's going on in the world. We are separated. We are unified in this church to make sure that we're on fire for God in this final hour. The service was just so filled with the Spirit. We're going to give you a little part of it right now. Move in. Be connected. Get engaged. And the Holy Spirit will fill you right there in the room where you're at. It's always a pleasure coming into your home. But right now, before that phenomenal word that I preached, we're going to bring on Shabak. I know you enjoy them. They'll be ministering. Put a praise on it. Enjoy. See you later.
There's a miracle in this room with my name on it. There's a healing in this room, and it's here for me. Oh, there's a breakthrough in this room.
Put a praise on it. Somebody put a praise on it. Let's go.
Got some new folks coming in here, Nina. Nina, are these your friends? Hallelujah, the Brazilians have landed. Prayer room. Peru. Scusa me. Italia. What do I know? Peru. God bless you. Welcome. Do they need headpieces too? You capisce? You understand? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you from Peru. Most important thing is Jesus is here. He told us you were coming. A few weeks ago, he told us you were coming. He said, get ready. The nations are coming. Somebody hearing me? He said, the nations are coming. Prepare yourself. How do we prepare ourselves? It's the power of the Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Spirit that you want. Yes? It's the Holy Spirit that you've come for. Yes? He's here. He's here. The Word of God says that you are blessed coming in and blessed going out. The Word of God says you are the head and not the tail. Do you understand that? You are somebody. Though the enemy tries to put you down and tell you you're a failure, this is never going to work. God says you are more than a conqueror. You have the authority and the power in Jesus' name to overcome. How many overcomers do we have in the house? What makes you an overcomer? The battle. We don't want the battle. But when the battle comes, when the test comes, we don't shout when it's over, we shout now. I'm an overcomer. My God can see me through. Do you understand that this morning? We're different because we wait to hear from God. He spoke to us 2 weeks ago and said, get ready. The nations are coming. And sure, indeed, in the last 2 weeks, we're seeing Africa, Peru, Brazil. Silver and gold we don't have for these people. But that which we have, we give, which is the power of the Holy Ghost, which is the living Word of God, the Book of Truth. How many of you have your Book of Truth with you today? Let me see it. Some of you are holding up your phones. That's cool. But I'm an old-fashioned Pentecostal gal. I bring the Word of God with me. Let me see your swords. Come on, let me see them. All right. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, all of you folks who have a switchblade, lift up your... lift up your phone. I know. I know. There it is. That's a switchblade. It's a small sword. Amen? Just make sure you ain't texting to anybody when I'm preaching. Because God will tell me, you know, he tells me those things. It's like when you're raising your kids, you know, you tell them, you be bad, God will tell me. And you ask them, how was your day? They go, good. Are you sure? Yeah. Did God tell you anything? Guilty, guilty kids. Well, I've got a hot word. How many want a hot word? A hot word of God, a seasoned word. Let him who has an ear hear what the Spirit is saying this morning. God has a message just for you. Don't look to the left or the right. You've come, and this word is for you. God is about to take you places you've never been. Is anybody on board? God is ready to tell you something you haven't heard in a while. Are you ready to listen? You're going to experience what you haven't experienced last week. It's a new week. Are you ready for something new? We're not going to warm up some leftovers, though there's nothing more delicious than ziti on the second day, a meatball on the second day. How about rice and beans on the second day? It gets married. It's so much more delicious. But that's not it today. You're getting premier. You're getting right off the table of God. Amen? Now, if you think that you've peaked in your walk with God, if you think that you're okay, you know, I'm all right, I'm not back in the world, not doing the things I used to do, this is good, this is good, this is good. God has so much more. How many want more? How many are ready to go up another level in God? Are you ready? God has more. If you want more, God wants to give you more. That's why he gave us the scripture in 1 Corinthians 2:9. He gave you this scripture.
But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor hath entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him.
How many love God this morning? How many say, I love you, Lord? I love you. Well, you're going to broaden your perspective of your God. Widen your horizons. You think you've had such good things in the past and everything's okay, and God is saying, more. I've got more because of who I am. I am the great and mighty God. I am able to do for you what no other plan, no other system could do. I own it all. He owns it all. How many want it? Lift your hand up right now. Just say, Lord God, I make myself available. I want more. I want to touch more people. I want to live a broader life. I need more so I can give more. More. John 14:12 tells us, this is for you who put your hand up.
Most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these he will do, because I go to my Father.
God has greater in store for you. Greater. He would have never given us this scripture if it wasn't his desire to do greater things with you. I thank God for the team that meets with me at 8:29 in the morning, because they are becoming so pliable, and they're becoming so flexible, and they're becoming raucous mouthpieces in the kingdom of God. And because of the knowledge that's coming through the glory class, they are expanding in their vision. See, everybody has to have a vision. Everybody's got to have a dream. Are you hearing me? A dream. Do you have one? You're not dreaming big enough. You've got to dream big, because you serve a big, mighty God. Are you hearing me? Big. Somebody say big. Now, he told us, in order to do the greater works, we've got to be the Book of Acts church. Okay? The Book of Acts church were reckless, because they knew him and they touched him. He told them, you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Somebody say power. Power over sickness. Power over sin. Power over poverty. Power over darkness. Power over fear. Power. You shall receive power. How ridiculous it would be if you tried to put something in your microwave and you press the buttons and nothing happens, to find out that the plug is not in. What good would the microwave be if it wasn't plugged in? What good are you if you're not plugged in to the power? He doesn't expect you to do anything on your own. He says, if you are in me and I am in you, watch out, world. we take over. And the words that we speak come to pass. The words that we speak, the words that we declare. Now, you need more than just church on Sunday. You need more than just church on Wednesday night. Jesus said, I am going to go away, but I am sending one to you. I am sending another to you. He is a parakletos. He is one that will not only be within you, but he will be around you, and he will defend you, and he will keep you. How many are so glad for the Holy Spirit? How many know the parakletos is with us? Every day, he said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Now, there is more than we can experience as believers than what the modern church has for us. We are told in Romans 8:11. You want to write that down.
But if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal body through his spirit who dwells in you.
Now, who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you. Say, he dwells in me.
He dwells in me.
Do you believe that? Don't just say it. Tap yourself. Say, he dwells in me. Say, neighbor, don't touch me. He dwells in me. You understand that? Same spirit, same power, same protector, same. We got to get to the point where we just stop just existing and we start operating in the authority and the power that is in us. Authority, power. Say it.
Authority, power.
Say it again.
Authority, power.
Do you have it in you? Do you have it in you?
Yes.
The same spirit is in you. A.W. Tozer said, the average Christian today is lukewarm, complacent, contented with life status quo, and not really willing to make changes. God bless us for and no more. And there's no real desire to have the Holy Spirit, the fullness of life, because that takes effort. That takes effort. We sang it this morning. I give myself away. You're not willing. Because in giving yourself away, it's going to cost you some of yourself. Amen? You believe that? Okay. He said, proof of desire is in its pursuit. Many have lost their desire for more of God. They say, I'm okay. I'm good. I'm not sinning. I'm a good person. Lost that desire for more of God. David the psalmist said in Psalm 42:1, as the deer pants for the water brook, so my soul pants for you, my God. Is your soul panting for God? Do you think about him during the day? You go to the restroom during the night. Are you praising the Lord? Are you giving God thanks that you can get out of that bed and walk to the restroom? Somebody hearing me? Charles Spurgeon said, actually, apart from the Spirit of God, you can do nothing extraordinary. Apart from the Spirit of God, you can do nothing extraordinary. How many want to operate in the extraordinary? How many want to operate in the supernatural? God bless you. I trust you've enjoyed this message today about the fire of God that's falling on churches around the world. And we are experiencing that right here at Fort Myers Christian Outreach Center. Just 2 weeks ago, I came back from the Holy Ghost fired up conference of CAP from King Jesus Ministries there in Miami. While I was there, the Holy Spirit spoke to me and told me that I needed to prepare myself because the nations were making their way here. And I needed to get the church ready with the power of the Holy Ghost to entreat these folks, welcome them, and they were going to be used mightily by God for their countrymen. And so the following day that I returned, this precious family came to church. Brazilian folks speaking Portuguese. And they came with a desire to be used of God. And so I enveloped them. I've met with them. I've prayed with them. And they're here again today. This time they brought more people to the church to experience what you experienced on TV today, which was the Word of God filled with power and fire. They're a precious couple, relatives, and this precious daughter is the translator. We welcome them to Retro, Getting It All Back. Tell me, Nina, what did you feel in the service today?
Pastor, é um prazer estar aqui com você.
Pastor, é um prazer. It's a pleasure being here with you, Pastor.
É, quando eu cheguei nesta igreja, vim como uma visitante.
When we first came here, we came just to visit the church.
But eu senti a presença de Deus aqui.
But I felt the Holy Ghost here.
E eu senti que Deus tinha um lugar para mim dentro dessa igreja.
And I felt that I had my place here in this church.
E eu pedi pro Espírito Santo.
And I asked the Holy Spirit,
colocar eu dentro do coração dessa pastora.
And she asked the Holy Spirit to put her into your heart.
E eu senti,
and I felt,
junto com meu esposo,
with my husband,
e falei com a minha filha.
And she talked to me as her daughter.
Esse é o lugar.
This is the place
que Deus preparou para nós.
That God prepared to us.
Estou muito feliz.
I am very happy to be here.
E eu convido você que
and
não tem
I
uma igreja.
You that doesn't have any church.
Você que fala português.
You that speak Portuguese.
Desde que você seja de Portugal ou Brasil.
If you're from Portugal or from Brazil.
Ou África.
Or Africa.
Que fala português.
That speak Portuguese.
Aqui tem um espaço para você.
You have a place here for you.
Como para outras nações também.
And for other nations.
Porque o Espírito Santo de Deus.
Because the Holy Spirit
faz maravilhas neste lugar.
Makes miracles in this place.
Hallelujah. And to you, handsome husband. Man of God.
E para você, esposo, homem de Deus.
What has God showed you going on in here?
O que Deus mostrou para você acontecendo aqui?
Os projetos que essa igreja trabalha.
The projects that this church work.
Os projetos que Deus plantou nessa igreja.
The projects that God planted in this church.
Encaixa com o que Deus colocou no nosso coração.
It closes with what God puts in our heart.
Uma igreja para as nações.
It's a church for nations. That's what God put in his heart.
O Espírito Santo.
The Holy Spirit.
Ele respeita as nossas diferenças.
He respects our differences.
Mas para Deus,
but for God,
nós somos um só povo.
We're only one.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This handsome, this is a nephew.
Yes.
God bless you. What have you felt here?
Que você sentiu aqui?
Eu pude sentir.
I could feel
muita presença de Deus.
The Holy Spirit, the presence of God.
E Espírito Santo também nesse lugar.
In this place. That's what he felt.
Amen. Amen. Well, this is what's happening here at the church. This vision is going forward the way the Holy Spirit told us it was going to go. And you might want to be a part. If you know somebody who is from Brazil, from a country, you know, these folks are now going to be taught. We're going to be aligning ourselves with ESL, which is English as a second language. We're going to teach them the English language. They are Brazilian people, missionaries to America. They have a desire to see their countrymen come to know Jesus Christ, and we're going to assist them. Give us a call. We'd love to pray with you right now. We're believing God, that God can move whatever nationality you are. He is the God of many nations, and there's one word, the Spirit of God, who is alive in us, will make you alive again. If you'd like a copy of this service today, we can only show you a little piece. If you want a copy, give us a call. The number's on the screen. We'll send you a copy of the service, DVD or CD. If you need prayer, call us right now. There's somebody here filled with the power of God that would love to pray with you. Consider coming to visit us here on 3500 Fowler Street. We would love to bring you in, love on you, and impart the Spirit of God. Till we see you again, be blessed, highly favored, and empowered to prosper.